Okay, so let's talk about moving data in. So one way to do this is all of you might have hard drives sitting around with like, you know, all your genomics data or everything that your lab has generated. Is that a common scenario still? Yes? Okay. Because I remember when I started my master's project, they just gave me two hard drives and said, here's your data, go deal with it. You don't have, and how do you transfer that from your personal computer to the computational clusters, right? You can't just FedEx and U-Haul it and ask them to plug it in and import it. And another thing to remember is Unix is unforgiving. So if you ever start command line and do rm minus rf, which is delete this file, there's no way of getting it back. I am lying and I don't want you to remember it because I want you to think about it that way. Is there is a backups, like it's called snapshots, and we do keep them. It's not really fun and it's very finicky. I wouldn't recommend trying to get that back. I want you to forget about it, but I want to mention it that there is a backup in case that happens.
On home directories.
Sorry, not?
Only on home directories.
Only on home directories, exactly. So only in your slash n slash u username. That's the only space that we have snapshots. But if you ever delete your data on Unix, it's likely it's deleted forever. It's not on your hard drive. Clusters are a shared space, so don't use 1 petabyte of data, please. It slows all of our machines up. It slows everybody else's jobs up. You don't want to lose data, and especially if you're a bioinformatician like me who does not do any of the field station stuff, I just think this data is coming, right? I'll delete it because I'm like, I don't need it. But then I don't know the amount of work that you spent going collecting that data and the amount of work that went into and the amount of money that went into actually generate all this data. And these are things sometimes, conveniently, I forget because I'm a bioinformatician. I like just get data on a computer. I don't do the work. But there's some things you should think about as well, and sometimes you can mention as well, saying that, hey, this is really hard data to get. Like, I think I got killer whale poop data. No idea how they collected it, which I think is super awesome. But then I'm sure there was a lot of work that went into actually get that. So instead of FedEx and U-Haul, think about it this way. We have something called Globus. It's a Globus endpoint. Globus is a file transfer, third-party file transfer. It's a paid subscription. IU pays for it, all the national clusters pay for it, most of them do, and so they all have an endpoint set up. It's essentially a website you can go to, and then you can basically say, go on to my IU computer, the scrap space, and take this file and drop it to the archive, which is the SDA. It's just a file transfer, it's just drag and drop button, essentially, and so you can move stuff from your personal computer to computational resources. In this case, you do have to download Globus onto your computer. And you have to make sure your computer is connected to the internet. But if you've ever done other file transfers, you know that if your internet is ever disconnected, you have to restart the whole file transfer again. Globus is nice that way. They have a software at the back end that just starts from where it stopped. So it's much more smoother. Apart from that, just remember when it's from your personal computer, you need to be connected to the internet. But if you're transferring files from computational resources to, let's say, SDA, which is the data archive, they're already connected to the internet on the back end. So you can actually stop the transfer, just shut down your computer, go do something else, and you'll get an email when the transfer is complete. Apart from that, most data servers online do have Globus now. NCBI doesn't, so I'll remove that. They're working, or we've been asking them to, but they've not done it yet. They do have Aspera and other file transfer clients, which are fast. And then I think that is all I have on this. There's lots of tutorials and slides. All of the slides will be available to you. So if you click on these hyperlinks, it should take you to our blogs where we have like a walk-in tutorial on how you get started with this, how you transfer. There are other ways to do it. If you're just transferring one file, that's a couple megabases. You don't really need Globus for that. You could use SCP, FTP, and there are other command lines. And all of that's available on the video and slides. Great.